Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. In this video, I'm going to show you how we install a spec seal LCC Firestop collar. Now, what I've got mocked up here is a simulation between a house on this side and a garage on this side. This will be the common wall between the house and the garage. So I've got my rim joist or band joist sitting on my sill plate, sitting on the block, and this will be the garage floor. Now, the other side of that would be the floor joist. And below the floor joist, below the subfloor, would be the basement or the crawl space. Now with radon mitigation, we're running pipe from the basement into the garage. And when we do that, we are penetrating a firewall, and we have to maintain the integrity of this firewall so that if there's a car fire in the garage, we don't want that smoke or flame spreading to the house through the hole that we cut in that firewall. So we stop the smoke with a product called smoke sealant. It's an intumescent sealant. The bigger hole, when this PVC pipe melts or burns away, is going to be protected by this Firestop collar. And how it works is this metal collar is screwed to the wall, and this black intumescent material expands up to 60 times when it's heated to close off the opening that's left by this pipe. So the common wall is typically a firewall between the house and the detached garage, and then sometimes the ceiling is also a fire rated wall, and you've got to maintain the integrity of that if that's the case. So I've got a 3-inch pipe, which means the outside diameter is 3.5 inches. So I cut a 4-inch hole through the sheetrock, and I cut a 3.625-inch hole through the rim joist or band joist. I want a 1/4 inch of smoke sealant to go around this pipe, 1/4 inch in diameter or in thickness, and I want it to be the thickness of this drywall at least. So that's why I switched from a 4-inch hole to a 3.625-inch hole. You could also cut a 4-inch all the way through and then put backer rod in there just beyond the back side of the sheetrock. All right, now it's time for us to add the intumescent smoke sealant. So this is just in a caulk gun, and I want to put that in around the pipe, and I want to make sure it goes back the full depth. All right, now it's time to install the Firestop collar. I can simply slide it over the pipe, or it does come apart. Say I had a fitting glued on there already, I can take it apart and then wrap it around. So I'm going to seal it back up. And then since we've got wood to screw into, we need to use a number 8 wood screw, and we need a 1-inch fender washer on that. So I've got a 1-inch fender washer with a 3/16 hole in the middle, and then my number 8 wood screw. So I can attach that. That's how you install a Firestop collar when you have wood to screw into. Now let's say I just had drywall like we find on the ceiling in many cases. There we just use a toggle bolt, something like this. Still use a 1-inch fender washer, have this toggle bolt go up through the drywall and then fasten it down, and then this would hold that Firestop collar in place. Kind of similar if you're going through, say we are going through a block wall, we drill our hole through the block, use this. Kind of the same process, except we'd use different anchors. We'd use like concrete anchors to secure it to the wall. So I hope you found the video helpful. If you did, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing. Check the description below for the products featured in this video. And if you'd like to see a couple videos that we install a Firestop collar, as well as a whole radon mitigation system, we'll put those two most helpful videos in the description as well. And until next time, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. Thank you so much for watching. Are you a radon mitigation contractor that would like to be more confident when giving estimates or installing a mitigation system? Would you like to reduce callbacks and stand out from your competitors? Would you like to offer more value to the families you serve? If so, we have a hands-on radon course coming up where we are going to focus on optimal mitigation, pressure field extension testing, suction point placement, pipe size, fan selection, and the effects of sealing. To sign up for our course, click the link in the description below. I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. Thank you so much for watching.